Grace and peace to everyone, and welcome to Sabbath School Study Group, where our focus in this series is the change of the law. And today's lesson is entitled The Law and Sin. So we're going to be looking at this relationship to get a better understanding as to what is God's will for worship and why is it that we have differences in worship, even differences in days of worship. This is what we're going to talk about this week. But let's start by understanding and coming from our focus verse in Daniel chapter 7, verse number 25. And here is the warning and the word from the Lord. And he shall speak great words against the Most High, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High, and think to change times and laws, and they shall be given into his hand until a time, at times, and the dividing of time. Lord, we pray for understanding, and we heed your warning and ask that you would make this real to us so that we could know what is your will for us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, our first point in our lesson today and this series is that the law is of God. We have to understand that this is who it belongs to. In fact, in Romans chapter 7, verse 22, it says, "For I delight in the law of God after the inward man." So here Paul is speaking about the law and he delights in it. This is not something where oftentimes, unfortunately, people say because of the New Testament, the law is done away with. But if it was done away with it, why would it be a delight to someone who wrote so many epistles on the basis of the law of God? Then back in Exodus chapter 31, verse 18, it says he gave unto Moses, this he being God, when he had made an end of communing with him upon Mount Sinai, two tables of testimony, tables of stone. And they were written with the finger of God. That is important to note. If all the materials to write in, why would he write it in stone? That has to be speaking to the validity, the permanence, and the reality of the law even now in 2018 from Exodus 31, 18. And here in Romans 6, 15, what then? Shall we sin because we are not under the law, but under grace? God forbid. Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourselves servants to obey, his servants ye are to whom ye obey, whether of sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness. So thank the Lord for verse 16, which clarifies verse 15, because you can read verse 15 and say, oh, we're not under the law. There is no law. But just go down and look at verse 16. And the latter part says, or of obedience unto righteousness, or obedience unto what is right. Well, how do we know what is right? What is righteousness? That is the law. Obedience unto the law. Still valid, but done so through the power of grace instead of the power of our own will. So now, when we see that this gift is from God to us, there is a permanence, there's a relevance, and there's a realness to the law that unfortunately this age has just kind of put to the side. We've made the law relative. We've made it very us-based. But we got to recognize that even though it is to us, it is from God. And he doesn't change, so what he says does not change. Well, in our second point, when we realize that the law is of God, well, guess what? Because of that, the law is good. It is good. In fact, in Romans chapter 7, verse 16, if then I do that which I would not, I consent unto the law that it is good. This is, again, the confession of Paul in Romans 7. The law is a good thing. The law is a good reality. It is God's will, so it's got to be good. Going down to verse 18, for I know that in me, that is, in my flesh, dwelleth no good thing. For to will is present with me, but how to perform that which is good, I find not. Here again, verse 18, it says, the law, God's will, even though we cannot and don't want to do it in our flesh, of itself, the law is good. In fact, it says, for the good, or the law, that I would, I do not. But the evil, which I would not, that I do. So here we see clear reference to the goodness of the law. In fact, as you saw it there before, Romans 7, 22, I delight in the law of God after the inward man. So we have to be very clear that because it's a gift from God, then it's all good. It's a thumbs up. Because that idea of the law is understanding it's the will of God. It's the character of God. It's his personality profile. And there's nothing bad about his personality. There's nothing bad toward us. Our issue and our problem is not the law. And our third and final point, we see that sin is bad. And that's our problem, not the law, but our sinfulness. In fact, in Romans 7, verse 12, It says, wherefore, the law is holy, and the commandment holy, and just and good. Again, repeating the reality of the law. But what's the problem? Well, here we are. Was then that which is good made death unto me? God forbid. But sin, there's the problem, that it might appear sin, here is the function of the law, to let us know what is sin, anything outside of the will of God, working death in me by that which is good, that sin by the commandment might become exceeding sinful. It is our sins that are the result of our sinfulness. Again, sin being the noun, the state, sins being the activity, the verb, the actions. And so that is our problem. Our problem is not the standard of the law. Our problem is that we are bent away from the standard. In fact, verse 14 of Romans, we know that the law is spiritual. It's of God. But I, that's us in our humanity, am carnal, sold under sin. Again, recognize the singular, the sinfulness of man. That's our fallen, broken nature that departed from God in the Garden of Eden. And as the sons and daughters of Adam and Eve, we now have inherited that nature. And because of that, we have a problem. So the issue is not what's going on the outside. The issue is internal, like a physician showing a patient the x-ray. Here's your problem. And when we understand where the problem is coming from, we forget the cosmetics and the external adjustments that we sometimes try to do to fix ourselves, but realize I can't just change what I do. But our problem is it's a change and it's a need to be changed in who we are. Because I am sinful, therefore I sin. So I need to be saved so that I can be holy. This is an invitation that God gives to us, and it is not performed by the law. Remember, the law just shows us the problem. The law is as powerful in our healing as an x-ray is. The x-ray just reveals what's wrong. But you need a physician. You need someone with the power and the technique and the skill and the interest to operate and to fix you. And I'm so glad that it's not somebody in a white lab coat. I'm so glad that it's not a prescription drug. I'm glad that it's someone who sits high and looks low and who wears not a white lab coat, but a robe of righteousness. And we call him Jesus. He is the one who's given us an opportunity now through his grace and through his love and through his righteousness to be made over again, to live in the light of his law. It's good to know. And that's why we're building our foundation as we understand the problem and also the promise. The problem is sin, but the promise is the grace of Jesus Christ. And he warns us here in Daniel 7:25, he shall speak great words against the Most High, our problem when we're dealing with the change of the times and laws. And he, this one who would speak against the Most High, will wear out the saints of the Most High and think to change times and laws. As we learn, the law is good. The law is of God. Therefore, it can't be altered, and it's not bad towards us. But they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the dividing of time. Let's continue to study together, but understanding that the law is our promise and sin is the problem. If you were blessed by what you just saw and heard, praise Jesus. We're glad, in fact, so glad that we want to invite you to visit our website, changeministry.org, where you will find this and so much more to encourage your walk with Christ. If you feel impressed, we'd also appreciate a donation that would support our ministry. We are trying to create a fund that would allow us to travel to any church, any school, anywhere, totally free of charge. And so we appreciate your support, not just of this ministry, but the work of change.